As God guides you along in your journey of experiencing fullness of life in Jesus Christ, He calls you into relationships. Relationships are the primary context in which we experience spiritual growth and transformation. Our relationships with God and our relationships with one another. That is why we have life groups at Bethlehem, so that we, in our relationships, can share life together in Jesus Christ.
I look so forward to coming to Bethlehem for my groups. It's like I can't wait to get here. So I have to, you know, make sure there's not police cars on coming on Wadsworth to stop me, because I just can't get here fast enough sometimes.
I was searching for something so I can be connected even more so, and not so much with the people connection. That's great, but more so with the word and just being fulfilled spiritually.
Literally, thousands of people have found fulfillment in life through life groups. Some of those groups gather around Bible study, some gather to serve, and some of those groups find life together in Christ, shared around a common interest, like musicals.
There is so much we can do.
And so I got sucked in. I used to do musicals when I was in high school, so I tried out for the musical the year after that, and just got sucked into it and love it, and met so many new people, a lot of good friends that I've kept through that, a lot of support.
A Saturday set building for the plays, Friends and Enemies, Noah's Ark. What a group of guys to get together and, you know, as one team and make something come alive. It's breathtaking.
It is amazing how God will use relationships to shape and transform you. In a congregation our size, the place where you can engage on a more personal level is life groups. And sometimes you end up making relationships that you never expected, like has happened with one prayer group called Moms in Touch.
I think the relationships that have developed amongst the women who otherwise may not have gotten together has been just wonderful. And then the support we've been able to give each other.
When you're going through life, it helps to know you're not alone, especially when you face some of life's challenges.
Let's see, it was like a couple months after the musical, I had some medical issues, and everyone pulled together, and a fundraiser was put together for me, and all my friends from musical and people that weren't even in the musical came and helped to support us, and it was the biggest blessing that we could ever receive. This school, church, everything, everybody pulled together.
Thanks to the supporters out there, people come together that you don't even know that care for you. And as in brothers and sisters in Christ, it's just amazing the grace that people bestow upon you. It's beautiful.
Story after story is told of how God works His blessings through the relationships established in life groups. These groups are something special.
The thing that I've noticed and felt in every one of the groups is that the love and the presence of God, they're different, but they're all similar. I just can listen and learn and feel. I just feel the presence of God there, and that's powerful.
Experiencing the love and the presence of God is what happens when believers in Jesus are willing to connect in relationships, authentic, real relationships, because life is real.
It's a time when, you know, you can be going into school and you've just had a challenging morning with your kids and then you walk in and say, "Hi, how are you?" And you kind of put on your happy mom face. But when you come in here and you're praying with other moms and you're sharing some real heart stuff, and you're sharing your weaknesses as a mom or your child's struggles and your insecurities start coming out, it's really real, and it's amazing how quickly we've gotten past that mask that we put on and get real with our emotions and our struggles.
You know, I'm around a lot of kids that are come from disadvantaged areas. And what I try to do as a coach, and also as a coach and as a Christian, is to try to touch them. What is a man? What is a man? What does a man do in certain aspects of their life? And then I try to listen. I don't force my Christianity on them, but when they ask me, then it just opens up the door, and my mouth just keeps going.
You will be amazed at how God will open the doors of opportunity, how He will use everyday life to change you, and where He will take you when you are connected to others who know the promises of God.
God is looking over you every day, and that you don't have, like, just getting up, let all your worries go away, be fully alive in Him, let Him take care of all your worries.
Being fully alive in Jesus, that's what it's all about. And you will find it in relationships, sharing life together in Jesus. You will find it in life groups.